Okay, explain to me one more time. What are we?
We are silhouettes.
Who's wet?
Not wet, you simple-minded cartoon. Et, like etiquette. This is silhouette animation.
We are silhouettes. Solid outlines of shapes. Our outlines represent people, but our interiors are featureless.
I'm not featureless. You're featureless. I have lots of great features. Check it out. Woohoo!
Oh my god.
Your brain is just as two-dimensional as you are.
So, how are we animated?
Silhouette animation is inspired by shadow play, practiced since medieval times by street entertainers from Japan to Baghdad. It entered Europe through the live performances of traveling showmen. Shadows played a central role in early cinematic experiments with light, and inspired silhouette animation as another form of stop-motion animation. The basic elements of shadow puppetry have been the same for almost 2,000 years. A light, a screen, and something to put between them to cast a shadow. When the art form began in India and China, the light was a flaming torch, the screen was a swath of cotton, cloth, and the puppets were very elaborate figures of carved leather operated with long rods of animal horn.
Pretty. Why aren't we this pretty? We're so simplistic.
The challenge of silhouette animation is being able to convey information without relying on many of the elements we often take for granted, such as color, facial expression, costume design, etc. Even Walt Disney knew the importance of silhouettes in animation. He urged his animators to work in silhouettes so that everything can be seen clearly. This animation is defined by poses that read with both definition and appeal.
So impressed.
You know what's really impressive?
What?
The oldest surviving feature-length animation.
Oh, I know that one. Disney Snow White.
Wrong. There's a film that predates Snow White, and it's a silhouette animation.
Whoa.
This is Lottie Reiniger's film, based on the Arabic folktale Prince Ahmed and the fairy Peribanu. While it is not the first animated feature, it is certainly among the earliest, if not the earliest surviving animated feature.
I didn't know about this either.
Oh, I like this movie. You all go ahead, I stay here.
Oh, now you find silhouettes interesting?
These aren't the only kinds of styles in silhouette animation, you know.
There's more?
Silhouette animation has been blended with live-action films as well. For example, Segundo de Chamon's 1909 film, Une Excursion Incoherente, am I saying it right, has a whole dream sequence in silhouette animation.
I want to go back to my theory.
Oh, grow up, will ya?
Then show me something new. Do they ever make silhouette animation anymore?
Of course they do, you silly twit. Contemporary French animator Michel Ocelot, or Michel Ocelot, however you say it, cannot say, made a silhouette animation with the use of white paper cutouts. Look how beautiful it all is.
And there was also an anthology film of his in 2010 called Tales of the Night.
And in Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, where Hermione tells the story of the three brothers, animator Ben Hibben paid direct tribute to Reiniger's shadow play.
Silhouette animation has even been used in contemporary games. Take the critically acclaimed Limbo for example.
That's so cool.
And to think it all started with a bunch of medieval puppets used by street entertainers, only to be given life by Lottie Reiniger's pioneering work in silhouette animation.
Speaking of which, you guys go on ahead. I'll stay here and do a little more research.
Oh god, you're incorrigible.
I don't know the meaning of that word.
He really doesn't.
Let's get out of here.
I love silhouette animation.